Well, Mike, it has just been a topic since the season ended, is what are the Lakers going to do? And of course, they've been in the headlines. I spoke to Dr. Jerry Buss yesterday, and I asked him if he was concerned about the state of his team. And he told me it's something that I have to address, and I am addressing it. I've been doing this for a number of years, and I will handle this. I will do what is in the best interest of the organization. That's all I am concerned about. And on his plate is the trade request regarding Kobe Bryant. I asked Dr. Buss directly if he would trade Kobe Bryant. He said, no comment. I also asked him if he was going to upgrade this roster and obtain another superstar. He said he's trying very hard, but he's only going to make a trade if, in fact, it improves this team, that he's not just going to make a trade for the sake of making a trade. Then the question also becomes is if they can obtain somebody, will that be enough to persuade Kobe Bryant to stay? And that question is just still out there in the cards and remains to be seen. And finally, even as big an issue as Kobe Bryant is, there is another major, major issue looming over the Los Angeles Lakers team right now, and that is Phil Jackson. He has 1 year remaining, and he has been offered a contract extension, and the team has been talking to him. Phil, who just had hip surgery, his second hip replaced, and is back in the office now and feeling much, much better, has yet to decide what he wants to do. He wants to see how his health is, how this season goes, and how the team and the direction goes. So there are some major, major issues. This will be one piece of the puzzle, but this is a very small piece, this pick, Mike.
It's number 19 overall, Jim, for a Laker team that went 42-40, was eliminated by Phoenix in the first round for the second consecutive year. And Rick Bucher, you were the one who started with all the conversations coming from Kobe Bryant about a potential trade request. It doesn't seem like he's backed off too far from that, even as the Lakers have made these little notions that we're going to go out and get a big-name player.
No, it hasn't changed at all. Those close to him told me that if they did get Kevin Garnett, he would have to pause and reconsider. But short of that, there is no change. And Kobe Bryant has basically gone dark and said, I'm going to focus on getting ready for Team USA. I'm not going to listen to what-ifs from the Lakers. My mind is made up. I want to be in another uniform. Now, there is a deal sitting on the table for the Lakers should they choose to take it, and that is Jermaine O'Neal from the Indiana Pacers for Andrew Bynum and Lamar Odom. But as of yet, they have decided they're not going to take the deal.
Andrew Bynum was their first-round pick 2 years ago. Jordan Farmar, their first-round pick last year. And Stephen A. Smith and Mark Jackson, this has fallen apart really quickly for the Lakers.
Let me say this real quickly. I spoke to Kobe Bryant personally. He doesn't want to come back with the Los Angeles Lakers. If Kevin Garnett came there, he would change his mind. They're not getting Kevin Garnett, so he doesn't want to be there. That's number one. And number two, and more importantly, this stuff about Phil Jackson. Who cares whether Phil Jackson comes back or not if you don't have Kobe? If you don't have Kobe, he's not going to win anyway. No matter how great he is, he won 6 titles with Jordan and Pippen. He won another 3 with Shaq and Kobe. What did he win without them? I rest my case.
So you're saying if the guy tried to talk Kobe into, hey, we want you to stay, and Kobe still didn't respond to Phil Jackson saying that, why should Phil Jackson sign a contract extension at this point if he doesn't know what the Laker future is?
He shouldn't. That's what he shouldn't. Move in a completely different direction. Phil Jackson's there because Kobe is there. You think Phil Jackson would be back in L.A. coaching the Los Angeles Lakers if Kobe wasn't there to be coach? Please. He said, please. Why are we wasting my time? I chill out in Montana. I go bike riding. Do something.
I'll tell you this. No way in the world organization could explain trading away Kobe Bryant and Shaquille O'Neal. You got some explaining to do. No question about it. Sit on Kobe Bryant and force him to continue to wear a Laker jersey. You do not trade the best player in the world.
Mike, let me tell you something right now. The Los Angeles Lakers, it will take them years to recover from this, if not decades, if you trade both of them.
Well, I hope whoever's name is going to get called heard all that. He's going to feel wonderful about becoming a Laker right now. 19th overall pick, Los Angeles Lakers. Time has run out, and the commissioner will come out and give us the name that the Lakers will add. And when you look at the draft, you talk about Andrew Bynum's development. They didn't want to trade him in offers. They came up, including Jason Kidd in the season. Ronnie Turiaf in the second round of 05. He is a good energy player who performed for them. Jordan Farmar last year moved his way toward a starting point guard role. So the drafts have been good the last couple times around, at least productive with players, and let's see who they will add at pick 19 of the draft.
With the 19th pick in the 2007 NBA draft, the Los Angeles Lakers select Javaris Crittenden from Georgia Tech.
They're bringing Dick Vitale on Crittenden, who Dick becomes the 7th freshman selected in this draft, and the Lakers take a point guard for the 2nd consecutive year. Dickie V?
Well, you know, you're talking about a guy, Mike, very physical, very strong, good handle. He has to be a better decision maker, but I think that will come. You know, hey, listen to all you guys tonight. I heard Stephen A. Smith going wild about Zach Randolph. I worry about one thing, Mr. Smith. Can he handle New York City? Never mind the court. He hasn't proven that he can handle life away from basketball. Same thing I worry about with Sean Williams as well. And then about Kobe Bryant. I'm tired, man. Kobe Bryant's going nowhere. That's dumb. That's almost as dumb as hearing about Tony Parker saying he went to sleep with his trophy from the MVP instead of Eva Longoria. How wacky is that?
Steven, would you like to respond to this?
Yes, I would. You know what, Dickie V, I love you to death, but we go back to what you said. First of all, you're absolutely right. Kobe's not going anywhere. I can't imagine it. But when you look at the 2003 draft compared to this, did you see the depth in that draft? I know you've been getting on me all day, and I love you, baby, but I disagree with you, okay? The 2003 draft is deeper, but this draft is impressive, so I'm not going to get on you too much, but stop hurting me, man. Stop hurting me.
Well, Steven, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll have a dinner bet, and I guarantee you that this draft is deeper than 2003.
I will look forward to it because you usually don't want to pay, so I'm looking forward to that, Dickie B.
You're right about that, buddy. You're right about that.
As you two men plan your dinner plans for 5 years from now, yeah, who's going to pay up on that? And the freshman guard, Jarvis Crittenden from Georgia Tech, who played 1 year there, and his mom moved him out of the Capital Homes Project in Atlanta, and he ended up getting out of trouble playing ball. We'll see how he does in Los Angeles.